The Philippine Central Bank agrees with Nomura's view. Inflation is set to go down starting August due to the lower tariff on imported rice. The BSP also vowed once again to safeguard price stability in line with its mandate. As for the National Economic Development Authority, it reaffirms its preparedness for the La Nina phenomenon and its impact on prices. The weather event is expected to lead to more typhoons in the country. The discovery of over 8,000 fake birth certificates issued to foreign nationals proves the Senate scrutiny of fugitive Bamban Mayor Alice Go is bearing fruit. That's according to Senator Riza Ontiveros, who says government needs to review its processes in issuing important documents. Ontiveros believes Go's case is not isolated, especially in the hometown of former President Rodrigo Duterte.
We were reasonable in worrying habang iniimbestiga si Guo Huaping o Mayor Alice Guo, worrying about nag-iisa lang ba siya or are there others? Panahon ni Duterte, nag-open door policy, may EO tungkol sa POGOs, and then we find out that there's this proliferation of fake birth certificates mula din sa home region niya. And we have to get to the bottom. Gaano ba kalaki, kalawak, ka-interrelated itong buong POGO phenomenon? And how have the disruption or the distortion of government agencies and government processes tulad ng dapat regular na pag-i-issue ng birth certificates been used para pahigpitin yung kapit ni Duterte at ng mga kasosyo niya sa negosyo at sa politika sa ganitong mga pagkasangkapan ng government institutions and procedures.
Ontiveros also believes Duterte's ally and former spokesman Harry Roque has links to illegal POGOs.
Nakapagtataka talaga sa dinami-dami ng bahay dito sa bayang Pilipinas, dun pa talaga sa sinasabing bahay niya natagpuan yung fugitive na yan. And again, that fugitive is identified by PAOK as the IT manager of Lucky South 99, which is the POGO company na inaareglo ni Attorney Roque. It seems that Attorney Roque and the people of Lucky South 99 are running in the same circles. That is really the subject of intense investigation on the part of my committee.
Senator Riza Ontiveros believes no excessive force was used when police served the arrest warrant against fugitive Pastor Apollo Quiboloy. The Senate is investigating the June 10 raid on properties of Quiboloy's Kingdom of Jesus Christ, where his followers claim they were terrorized by the police. Ontiveros says this is just an overstatement. Quiboloy, who is accused of sexual abuse and trafficking, remains at large.
PNP is simply fulfilling their mandate as the primary public order institution in our country. Nung pinasok ng PNP yung Glory Mountain or yung kingdom ni Apollo Quiboloy, it was to effect the warrant of arrest. Pag nailagay pa siya sa red list ng Interpol, hindi lang iisa o dadalawang law enforcement agencies ang hahabol sa kanya. Dapat magpakita na lamang siya at sagutin yung mga akusasyon laban sa kanya.
On another issue, Ontiveros questions what she calls the flip-flopping of the Marcos administration on the International Criminal Court's drug war probe. Although government maintains it will not cooperate with the ICC, it also says it will not stop the ICC from interviewing suspects in the case.
Itong issue ng ICC, bagamat it's one of the most important issues on which the former Uniteam is singing different tunes way beyond politics na ito, kahit para sa administration. Sila rin, they had their own doubts and deep discomforts about it, kaya nga naging paiba-iba yung position at statements nila. Kahit yung administrasyon, nakikita niya na wala siyang kawala eh. Kung gusto niyang ibalik sa mas maayos na pagtingin ng mundo sa administrasyon, they have to show, just as in the West Philippine Sea, dito rin sa ICC, yung pag-comply natin sa mga international standards.
Google found to be in violation of the U.S. antitrust law. A U.S. judge ruled Google spent billions of dollars to create an illegal monopoly and become the world's default search engine. The ruling paves the way for a second trial to determine potential fixes. It is also a big win for U.S. antitrust enforcers taking on big tech companies and their market dominance. Google parent Alphabet said it plans to appeal the ruling.